Hey guys, how's everybody doing today? It is Monday, and I am into the final week of my summer vacation. Oh, I can't believe it finished so quickly. Still got a couple days left, but man, I'm not really looking forward to it. I mean, I'm looking forward to getting back to work, but I'm not. You know how it is when you're off work for an extended period of time. Anyway, guys, yesterday, I should have made this video yesterday, yesterday was 1 year and a half since I was put in the hospital. And some little things here and there. I'm going to put a picture up here. We'll just go ahead and cover the screen now. This is a picture of when I went into the hospital last year, on the day I went in the hospital, maybe the second day. And yesterday, the picture on the right that you're looking at is from yesterday. And somebody had asked me to maybe give a recap of the last year and a half and what I'm looking forward to in the next year and a half. You know, the past year and a half has been kind of a challenge, I guess. There's the smoking really hasn't been a problem at all. Not smoking, that doesn't bother me at all. Eating, I don't really miss all the junk food. I don't really miss all of the junk food. Sorry, I just got a message pop up on the screen here. I don't really miss all the junk food. In the summer, there were a couple times I kind of wanted to have some ice cream, you know, because it was hot out. But even then, the desire wasn't really all that strong. Some things that I've noticed, I can't eat mayonnaise anymore. I don't like the taste of it anymore. I don't know why. I don't really use too many condiments anymore, except for maybe mustard. I like mustard. Mustard tastes really good. Ketchup's kind of burned out on me, and so is mayonnaise. You know, I feel worlds better than I did last year, of course. I'm still big, you know, but I get around a lot better than I used to, and you know, we're going out for our walks again recently, and I expect things to pick up here, you know. But you know, I'm doing really well. My insulin's almost down to nothing. I have two shots that I take in the morning. One is just like, I mean, it's like, I mean, there's hardly anything in it. So that's going well. Blood pressure's fine. Everything's going really well, you know. Just trying to keep on top of it. I'm staying away, you know, like I said, I'm staying away from the junk food as much as I can. The problem with my weight isn't garbage food. Like, you know, I'm not eating like a ton of candy or crap or anything like that. It's just I'm eating more than I should. Okay. Like I, you know, and I've said this before. It's like a broken record almost. I mean, I'll have a full chicken breast or maybe even two chicken breasts instead of half of one that I should have. Or, you know, I might have an extra helping of whatever, right? But, you know, on the other side of that, the amount of vegetables that I eat now compared to what I ate, a year ago, oh my God, day and night. I eat a lot of vegetables now. Vegetables that I wouldn't have touched a year ago. So, you know, there's that, you know, so which is a positive, you know, and that's the thing. You gotta pick out the positives in these things, and, you know, but I've been a little complacent. I admit it. You know, I took a lot of time off from the exercise and stuff like that. But, you know, I realize that as a fat person, I laid the blame on my doctor, as any fat person would do, a fat, lazy person. I told you guys before, my doctor had said for me not to walk too much because it would damage my knees. And if I damage my knees, there's really nothing they could do about it. So when he said that, I was like, now I don't have to walk anymore. Yeah, right? Took advantage of that. When I should have just said, you know, forget that and just kept on walking, which I didn't. And which I'm doing now, you know. And because I've realized that going for walks or not going for walks, my knees don't feel any better, you know, not going for a walk. So why the hell not, you know? It's, you know, Just go ahead and get it over with. So, you know, we're back to walking again recently. And, yeah. You know, the complete summer vacation wasn't a complete waste. I've been doing crunches, you know, 60 a day. And spurts of 15. I've been doing some stretching and stuff like that. And, yeah. Anyway, cigarettes. Now, this was... Sorry about that, guys. Got cut off. Anyway, what I was going to tell you about the smoking was the data from yesterday. Let me pull this up real quick. I've got it here on my phone. Where the hell did it go? No, it's not in my phone. Yes, it is. It's over here. Okay. As of yesterday, I've saved $2,464. 1 year, 181 days smoke-free. And cigarettes not smoked, 10,950. Which by now, that would be 11,000. Because I would have smoked two packs by now. So, yeah. 11,000 cigarettes. I tell you what, I know that my lungs clearing up is going to take like forever. If I've got that much time left. Because I smoked for 35 years. But I tell you, man, the breathing is day and night. Day and night, for sure. Yeah, there's been huge improvement in the breathing category since I stopped smoking. I don't get much phlegm anymore. You know, I don't get any of that. I don't have the little whistler in the back of my throat. I don't get as winded as easy. I find, you know, the biggest part of getting tired now is my back. You know, and as I've said before, I think that's the core muscles that need work on. So that's, you know, I started doing the crunches and stuff like that. So anyway, we'll see how it goes. So anyway, guys, it was good talking to you tonight. If you guys got any questions about anything, just go ahead and leave them down below. And we'll talk to you soon. Don't let your meatloaf.